Now, Cajun Miles presents Counsel's Corner.
Welcome back to Counsel's Corner. Bill Griffith along with Shannon Miles and Jamie Cage of Cage and Miles Family Law. And let's dig a little deeper, can we, into this whole contested matter, often contested matter, of child support, beginning with what exactly it is.
Child support is the amount of money that one parent can be ordered to pay the other parent, typically the parent that has primary custody of the child or children. And it's really the money that is supposed to go to help pay for the education and housing and food and everything that goes into supporting the child.
All the normal expenses.
Right.
Well, is there any limit to how much support can be ordered?
So the court actually uses a guideline formula to calculate child support. Oh. So the court will input, or your attorney will input, factors such as time percentage with the child, income of the parties, and other tax deductions, other financial factors. The program will spit out a number, and that's essentially your base child support amount.
So who has custody longer during the week actually can affect the child support in this case.
It will.
Interesting about that. Well, here's one. What if one of the partners refuses to pay?
Well, that happens, surprisingly. There are people out there that don't want to pay their child support. Mm. And in that case, there are some enforcement things that we can do, that we can assist clients with. One of those, for instance, would be obtaining a wage garnishment. So that's where you get an order for the employer to pay the child support directly to the supported parent, as opposed to having to wait for the parent to pay themselves.
And I see a parent saying, but I don't have a job.
Yes, that also happens, unfortunately.
Yeah, yeah.
So the court does have the ability to impute income to a parent. So basically, the court can consider the ability of the spouse to work and the opportunity for employment out there for that particular individual. The court can then use that imputed income number in the guideline formula and get a child support amount based off of that.
Boy, it sounds like it's really important to have an advocate on your side like Cajun Miles.
Absolutely.
It really does, because there's so many ins and outs and permutations in all of this,
right,
isn't there?
It's not black and white.
It's not black and white. And again, these are general principles, not legal advice. If you want that, you need to go to CajunMiles.com or call 858-943-2060.